Infrastructure is another top priority of the next PPPC government, says the party's presidential candidate, Irfan Ali. Nandalal weary of more attempts to delay long overdue general and regional elections. Gunmen bound and rob mother and daughter in broad daylight as out-of-control crime continues. And in sport, Guyana Amazon Warriors looking to open CPL 2019 campaign on winning note. These and more coming up after the break. Stay with us.
Secure your property, secure your life. Get the best security service from us at KGM Security Services Incorporated. Highly trained armed and unarmed officers at affordable rates. We offer armed mobile patrols, personal security, cash escort, alarm monitoring, quick response units. Also, rental of executive vehicles with armed guards. 74 Axora Avenue, Bellaire Park, Georgetown. Contact us on 663-3227, 699-0084 or 654-1800. KGM Security Services Incorporated. We are your source for security.
Did you know almost one-third of deaths in Guyana are heart-related? Chronic inflammation is the root cause of atherosclerosis, the process that leads to cholesterol-clogged arteries. You can now lower high triglyceride levels with Omega XL and reduce the dangerous inflammation that causes these problems. So to ensure a healthy heart and reduce your risk of disease, get your Omega XL today. Live long, stay strong with Omega XL.
Of the population around the world have stomachal problems because the water is contaminated. Some of these stomachal problems are diarrhea, cholera, typhoid, filaria. Avoid this sickness with the latest water purifier. Drink clean, fresh mineral water at all the time. Just put water from the pipe, the river, or rainwater at the top of the water purifier, and the system is going to remove all the impurities. Easy to use, easy to sample, no current, no batteries. Purify more than 10,000 liters of water.
Everything is connected, our planet, our water sources, including the water we drink. Sometimes harmful bacteria end up in our streams and canals. Although treated, the risks are high. You can prevent this pollution and contamination by maintaining your septic tank and grease traps. Call the experts at Pooran Brothers Disposal Incorporated on 264-1239 or 603-5050. Keeping it clean is what we do best.
Looking for fresh, tender, and flavorful meat? Then check out Rossignol Butchery for steaks, burgers, sausages, minced meat, fish, and chicken. For a tasty, attractive cocktail, we have a wide variety of packaged deli meats and cheeses to decorate your platter. We also stock a wide assortment of canned goods, seasoning salts, sauces, and marinade, all in a highly hygienic, welcoming atmosphere with warm and welcoming staff to cater to all your needs. Rossignol Butchery, we meet your needs. 73 to 74 Church Street, Georgetown. Telephone number 223-00.
Hey, credit! You know, since me find a Bataya Future Shop, me house look nicer than you one. Hey, credit rate. How you can afford to buy all them things?
I'm going to tell you.
Now I'm going to catch again our secret.
No, come on, man. I'm magic. You're too fast. Mind the business.
Excuse me, Uncle. Tell me something. How credit can't afford to buy so much thing from Ioni now walk no way?
It's because now we introduce our new discount card.
Apply now for your discount card at Tayo Future Shop. Every time you shop using your discount card, your percentage increases. Start from 5% off. Your next purchase, 7% off. Then 10% off, etc. Until you start getting wholesale and factory price. Check in store for more details. Conditions apply.
Help me get me tire discount card. Wait, man. What you gotta do next, man? Buy the whole entire store?
Good evening and welcome to this, our Wednesday, September 4, 2019 edition of A News Update. I'm Ashley Scotland. Our top story this evening. Presidential candidate of Guyana's single largest party, PPPC, Irfan Ali, will not forget the hinterland when he succeeds caretaker president David Granger. He plans to allocate $2 billion minimum each year to upgrade infrastructure in the areas.
PPPC's Irfan Ali has already planned what will occur in the hinterland if he secures a victory at the imminent elections.
We are going to invest heavily in hinterland roads, in improving transportation link, in reducing the cost of transportation. We cannot have a situation where many communities in important areas, both from a social and economic standpoint, are cut off from us as a result of rainy season for 5 or 6 months in the year, or 4 months of the year. It is not sustainable. It's not sustainable for the investors or for us as a country. And it drives up costs of living in these areas.
He noted such upgrades will attract more investors in the hinterland, whether it is for a carbon credit market, forestry, mining, or tourism. Ali highlighted the more investors in the hinterland will mean more job opportunities for persons in the area. Considering the budding potential of the hinterland and the need to widen Guyana's economic earnings, presidential candidate Ali made a huge financial pledge, which will be refreshed annually.
$2 billion we're looking to set aside every year at a minimum in terms of helping to maintain and build hinterland roads.
Godfrey Brooms, MTV. News update.
Former Attorney General Anil Nandlal predicts that the struggle for elections will continue since the proposals put forward at the Guyana Elections Commission for the printing of national identification cards will stretch the timelines for the holding of elections. Details from Sandy Ramutar.
Former Attorney General Anil Nandlal is not pleased with the pace in which the Guyana Elections Commission is moving in keeping with the shortest possible time frame for the holding of elections. Nandlal said there will be a long struggle for the holding of elections since the commission again failed to yield a decision. He said the processes post-registration will run into months as the commission looks to start the production of national identification cards. The manufacturing of the national identification cards will see timelines ranging from 92 to 140 days.
And we don't even have the technological capacity in Guyana to do it. And that's why they're exploring other countries. They're looking at Jamaica and they're looking at other jurisdictions. Do you know how long it will take? Jamaica are already to print some couple thousand ID cards. They say they will take several months to do a couple thousand ID cards. That is the state of play. And all of this can be simply avoided if they put this matter to a vote and the chairman vote in the correct way.
He suggested that the current voters list be refreshed with a cycle of claims and objections, putting an end to the lengthy processes. The electoral body is still to decide whether it intends to move to an extensive claims and objections exercise. The commission is set to meet again on Friday. Sandy Ramutar for MTV's News Update.
Meanwhile, Nandlal said he was stunned with the staggering data accumulated from the house-to-house registration, which saw almost half the population registered in just 6 weeks. Details from Sandy Ramutar.
Former Attorney General Anil Nandlal is not pleased with the data collected from the house-to-house registration exercise. The Guyana Elections Commission has registered 370,822 persons from July 20 to August 31, 2019. The former Attorney General is stunned at the staggering number of registrants who were able to register in just about 6 weeks. To bolster his point, Nandlal said it currently stands at approximately 600,000, which took 15 months to accumulate in 1998. Nandlal is baffled that the Elections Commission was able to register almost half the population in an exercise that the People's Progressive Party supporters boycotted.
They were still able to get 370,822 in 6 weeks. Had they continued for 12 months or 15 months, which is the normal time it has taken to do house-to-house registration in Guyana, the last four times it was done, then we would have ended up with a list, I don't know, over 2 million, 3 million. That is why this data is dangerously flawed. This data that the GCOM commissioners, the government commissioners, are fighting to be inputted and to be used is deeply flawed, deeply erroneous, dangerously erroneous.
He is contending that the data accumulated during the registration process is flawed after examining a number of registrants that are from the localities with supporters predominantly from the People's Progressive Party. The information garnered from the registration process will be merged with the existing National Register of Registrants database.
For a long time now, I have worked at several elections, so I know the areas as good as most people. And these statistics that I'm looking at here are deeply flawed. Deeply flawed. They are padded and they are bloated. And it is this, if these statistics are used for electoral purposes, then they will not be free and fair elections in Guyana. And I want to make that very, very clear. That's my personal opinion, based upon what I have seen and based upon what I know.
While the Damara Harbour Bridge has been reopened to restricted vehicular traffic, authorities have said that unladen and fully laden trucks will not be allowed on the bridge until further notice. In a public notice, the Public Infrastructure Ministry said that all essential services and private businesses are asked to exercise patience as engineers are working tirelessly and continuously with little sleep to ensure that things return to normalcy. It said that it is important that the bridge is used with absolute caution, since premature use of the bridge could result in much more severe damage, which will not be beneficial. The ministry said that as soon as clearance is given for unladen and fully laden trucks to utilize the bridge, the public will be informed. The Damara Harbour Bridge was closed in the wee hours of Monday after a tug and barge crashed into it, causing damages in three areas. This had led to chaos on Monday morning as workers, business persons, and school children from the West Demerara region were forced to use the Vredenhoek Georgetown crossing. Late yesterday afternoon, the bridge was reopened to light vehicular traffic. Still to come after these messages, gunmen bound and robbed mother and daughter in broad daylight as out of control crime continues. And in sport, Guyana Amazon Warriors looking to open CPL 2019 campaign on winning note. This and more when we return. Stay with us.
Let FiberTech help you to renovate, refresh, and redecorate your kitchen. Spice up your kitchen with decorative colors, finishes, and accessories. Choose from an array of designs and beautiful granite colors that are blended to suit your choice. FiberTech Lifetime Kitchen is durable, termites-free, and water-resistant. Enjoy 1 year factory warranty along with our after-sale service. So come on in and let us help you choose wisely.
Using Softex toilet tissue, available in leading supermarkets countrywide. Softex is always silky smooth because it's made from virgin pulp and babies love it. Softex comes available in single rolls, economy pack, six pack, and one dozen packages. Just perfect for any budget. Manufactured and distributed by BPATS Paper Manufacturing, Eccles Industrial Site. For more information, telephone 622-4197.
Planning a cleanup? We can help. Sivan's Waste Management skip bins can be provided for home renovation projects, yard cleanups, or construction sites. It's simple. Step one, just pick up the phone and give us a call. Step two, we deliver the skip bin size of your choice. Step 3, load the skip with all of your junk. And finally, step 4, we take it all away. It's that simple. Bins are also available in various sizes, so there's no job that's too big or too small. Call Sivan's Waste Management today at 218-1455 or 218-1156.
Broaden your horizons when thinking about investing long-term. Buying shares in one of the companies traded on the Ghana Stock Exchange allows you to participate in the success of that company. Unlike interest from banks, dividends from shares are tax-free, and profit from any increase in share price does not incur capital gains tax. You can buy shares through a stock broker. Visit www.gasci.com for details. Shares are freely transferable and can be sold for cash when needed. Invest through the Stock Exchange. One market. Greater returns.
Hey, you have a growing flesh there, and there too, and there is another one. Those ugly and annoying growing flesh, like a plague, ignoring them, and before you know, you have them everywhere. SlimJet presenting Coleomac, the most effective growing flesh and wart remover. Painlessly remove ugly growing flesh is the quick and effective way. Get soft, smooth, growing flesh-free skin, guarantee. Just apply Coleomac twice a day and the growing flesh just dry up and fall off. Easy, quick, and painless. Stop suffering and feeling embarrassed. Remove those ugly growing flesh with Coleomac. Only at SlimJet, City Mall, second floor.
Welcome back. You're watching MTV's News Update. The police are now on the hunt for three men who robbed a woman and her daughter at their home in broad daylight, leaving them bound, then making good their escape as crime, particularly armed robberies, continue to skyrocket. Sections of the media reported that Indrani Sugrim, 58, and her daughter Sabrina Sugrim, 30, was at home in their concrete house located at Lot 3, Suzdak Public Road, East Bank, Demerara, when the men struck. At about 14 hours 20, the daughter was sleeping and her mother was in the living room when one of the perpetrators came under the pretext of purchasing coals. He paid with a $5,000 bill, and it was while Mrs. Sugrim was heading inside to provide change for the alleged customer, the man and accomplice followed her. The bandits, reportedly all armed with handguns, demanded cash and jewelry. One of the intruders then went into the daughter's bedroom and woke her up while also demanding cash and jewelry. Fearful for their lives, the victims complied. The men carted off a gold chain valued $100,000, two diamond rings valued $400,000, a DVR valued at $45,000, and an undisclosed sum of cash belonging to Mrs. Sugrim. The daughter was relieved of a Samsung cell phone valued at $70,000, gold chain valued $200,000, two gold rings valued at $175,000, and $180,000 in cash. The men then bound their victims' hands and feet before escaping. As a result of the stolen DVR, police have been unable to obtain closed-circuit television footage. The Georgetown Chamber of Commerce has made it categorically clear that it will represent the interest of businesses here in the same way the United States advocates for local content. Details from Sandy Ramatar.
The Georgetown Chamber of Commerce has flagged the United States Ambassador Sarah Ann Lynch concerns that the local content policy might scare away foreign investors. Senior Vice President Timothy Tucker said the Chambers will do what is best for businesses here. He reiterated the Chamber's support for local content policy and legislation for the oil and gas industry. He said Lynch is a public servant of the United States and it was expected she's doing what is best for businesses in the United States. Lynch wants focus to be placed on holding companies to international standards. For this reason, she said it is paramount for Ghana to look at foreign investors as partners in growing the economy as the country gears up the commercially produced oil come 2020. But Tucker said he has observed U.S. President Donald Trump is very pro-local content to his country, so likewise, the GCCI is well on track to be pro-local content. At a recent forum, President of the GCCI, Nicholas Boyer, said the third draft of the local content policy dictates that all operators and their subcontractor companies should show a preference for domestic suppliers as long as performance, quality and delivery are competitive with international performances and prices. But he said that is not an easy matchup for local businesses. The APNU-AFC coalition has been facing an avalanche of criticism for its failure to ensure local content policy is placed to ensure that Guyanese businesses get a cut of the cake ahead of the forced oil. As it is, there is no legal framework in place to force foreign oil companies to utilize the goods and services of Guyanese, a key feature that will ensure locals benefit from the emerging industry.
The 16% interest rate being offered by commercial banks when businesses apply for loans has been cited as one of several challenges that faced by local businesses in Guyana. This was expressed by executive member of the Georgetown Chamber of Commerce and Industry, Timothy Tucker. He cited some other sources of capital that businesses use in this modern age. Some examples he used were crowdfunding, equity, venture capital, and initial public offerings, IPO. Crowdfunding involves a business raising money from a large number of people in an open space, usually internet-based. Equity is using the difference in the value of an asset, for example, and the value of the liability, such as the remaining mortgage, in order to raise money. Venture capital has been described as private equity. On the other hand, an IPO is the act of raising money through offering shares of a company in the stock market. But the difficulty in getting affordable commercial loans continue to be a major bugbear for the business sector in the last couple of years. Over the past 3 years or so, many commercial banks have been faced with a high percentage of non-performing loans, which may have triggered higher interest rates and reluctance to lend in the current harsh economic conditions facing Guyana. Transparency Initiative of Guyana Incorporation has flagged the exploration license given to ExxonMobil as illegal since it was not tendered in accordance with the Procurement Act of 2003.
ExxonMobil contract was signed in 2016, giving the company authority to explore in Guyana's waters for possible oil, which was eventually found in large quantities. However, Transparency Initiative of Guyana Incorporated, TIGI, says the award of exploration licenses ought to have been put to public tender. As such, the corruption watchdog affirmed, and I quote, "Every license which has been awarded without public tender is illegal, including the 2016 contract with Exxon." End of quote. TIGI based its statements on the Procurement Act, which defines a procurement as the acquisition of goods by any means, including purchase, rental, lease, or hire purchase, and the acquisition of construction, consulting, or other services. The agency says the government is being willfully blind as calls for the blocks to be auctioned have all been rejected. Not only Exxon's contract, but all subsequent agreements which have been signed since 2015 are offensive to the laws of Guyana, including the Constitution, says TIGI. Reporting for MTV News Update, Godfrey Brooms.
The Guyana leg of the Caribbean Premier League 2019 is set to commence tomorrow, Thursday, and will be held at the National Stadium Providence on the following dates and time, the 5th, 7th, and 8th of September 2019. To facilitate the free flow of traffic, the following traffic arrangements will be put in place on the specified dates and time. The eastern lane of the eastern carriageway of the East Bank Public Road from Nandi Park to the Guyana National Stadium will be used only for patrons with vehicles to access parking. Traffic proceeding south along the western lane of the eastern carriageway of the East Bank Public Road will be allowed to flow continuously south to permit the free flow of traffic. Public parking will be available at Providence Access Road, Red Road, in the compound on the south side of the road. VIP and paid parking will be available at the second access of the Guyana National Stadium, the northern tarmac for paid parking and the southern tarmac for VIPs parking. VVIPs and officials will use Greenfield Access Road for entering and exiting the stadium. No parking will be allowed on both sides of the eastern and western carriageway in front of the stadium. Patrons are advised to use carpooling and share a ride to ease the congestion. Signs will be erected to guide patrons. The same traffic arrangement will be in place for Saturday and Sunday, when two other matches will be played at the stadium. The Liberty and Justice Party has proposed to extend paid maternity leave to a year if it succeeds at the next elections. However, that party is unlikely to succeed at the polls, considering no new party has won its first elections in over 30 years.
The Liberty and the Justice Party is promising mothers to extend the paid maternity leave to a year. Currently, mothers are allowed only 13 weeks maternity leave, and only in extreme cases it can be extended to another 13 weeks. This is part of an overhaul of the healthcare system, according to the party's manifesto. The party's manifesto indicates a free universal early education and child care services. However, while the party is pushing an extended maternity leave, it speaks nothing of paternity leave that is leave for fathers. The Women and Gender Equality Commission had presented to the Speaker of the National Assembly, Dr. Barton Scotland, on March 5, a report including paternity leave for men. Reporting for MTV News Update, Godfrey Brooms.
Here is Lynn Griffith with MTV's Court Roundup.
A fisherman today appeared before Magistrate Leron Daly to answer to a wounding charge. 27-year-old Calvin Murray denied the charge against him, which read that on September 2 at Waramuri Village, Morocco Northwest District, he unlawfully and maliciously wounded Shane Peters with intent to maim, disfigure, disable or cause grievous bodily harm. According to reports, on the day in question, the virtual complainant and defendant went to a birthday party where they drank alcoholic beverages and became intoxicated. Later in the night, the men got in an argument. The defendant allegedly went away and armed himself with a cutlass, after which he returned and dealt the victim several chops to the left leg. He was rushed to the Kumaka District Hospital and was later referred to the Saudi Hospital, where he remains a patient. Police prosecutor Sanj Singh objected to bail, citing the fact that the victim is still hospitalized and in a serious condition. As such, bail was refused and Calvin Murray was remanded to prison until September 9. Reporting for MTV's Court Roundup, Cillian Griffith.
Coming up after the break, MTV's Sport Update and more. Stay with us.
Beeson Windows and Doors, fully equipped to handle all your commercial projects. Whether you're constructing a small or large commercial building, residential property, or just upgrading your home, they got you covered. Beeson Windows and Doors, providing unmatched quality windows for your home, office, and commercial building. Located at 1228 Eccles Industrial Site. For more information, call 662-4197 or 226-1292.
Modern Optical Service has made it even better by introducing its budgeted spectacle line, starting as low as $10,000 for a single vision lens and $12,000 for a bifocal lens, available in tinted or clear, complete spectacles at affordable prices. So hurry down to our main office at 316 Middle Street or Lot 14 Diamond Public Road opposite Demerara Bank. Enjoy over 60 years of eye care experience at affordable prices. Modern Optical Service, your eye care professionals.
You can be a millionaire by only spending $100 on a Daily Million ticket. Simply pick any five numbers from 1 to 26, or you can buy a quick pick for your chance to win the Daily Millions. Purchase your tickets daily, Monday through Saturday, to get a chance to win $1 million every day. So, feeling lucky? Then buy a Daily Millions ticket today. Remember, a ticket today could make you rich today.
BM Sote Auto Sales presents Vehicle Leasing. Trade in with the old, out with the new. Low down payment deals as low as $500,000. Duty-free deals for anyone with a duty-free concession. 5% cash back. Buy any vehicle cash and get 5% off instantly. Visit our showroom for more info or call 231-8451 or visit our Facebook page, BM Sote Auto Sales.
Reliability is not an option. You need a supplier you can trust. This skilled technician depends on Forfun and Mendes for heavy-duty tools. This landscaper earns a living using still equipment. High rates of production and recovery lead to this sawmiller trusting his operation to a wood miser. Mothers trust the water filtration systems for the health of their families. Thanks to the automatic backup systems, you'll never be left in the dark again. Forfun and Mendes, offering you solutions you can depend on.
Mark?
I'm in the kitchen.
This is amazing! I love your tiles.
Make an impression with the finest tiles imported by Lens. Lens has a huge selection of various tiles for your wall, floor, and pool needs. All of our tiles are of grade A quality, which are the highest quality tile rated. That means they last longer and are less likely to damage or crack. We're the sole distributor for many reputable companies around the world. At Lens, we have special deals for contractors and bulk shoppers. Shop at any of our three locations to get the best in tiles. Lens, our product, your creation.
Ready to ride away a winter on a brand new motorcycle? With Ultra Lubricants Oil & Go, it's so easy. Purchase any Ultra Lubricant at an authorized dealer. Get your coupon, fill it out, drop it in the box, and you could be one of six lucky Ultra winners to ride off on a bike. And here's the secret tip. Get two chances to win when you purchase Ultra Power Max 4T. Ride away a winner. Oil & Go with Ultra Lubricants. Promotion runs from 1st of March to the 31st of September. Conditions apply. See press and Facebook for details. Ultra Lubricant, distributed by Industrial Supply of Guyana, Inc. and available nationwide.
Hours ahead of their first match of the 2019 Hero CPL, the Guyana Amazon Warriors and St. Lucia Zooks are both confident and eager for their clash tomorrow at the Guyana National Stadium, Providence.
Captain of the Guyana Amazon Warriors, Shoaib Malik, disclosed this year they are a consistent team who have another opportunity to win the title, but their focus lies in remaining consistent in the tournament.
Well, if we look at Warriors' performance over the years, was pretty consistent. It's just that we have never crossed that line where we could hold the trophy. But yes, here is another opportunity. And the process is long. We are not just looking at the trophy. We are just looking at the thing, what we can do, what we have in our hands, and that is to stay consistent in the tournament. And the first few games are very crucial for any team, and we are looking forward to do well, especially we starting from home games.
Meanwhile, commenting on what the St. Lucia Zooks have to do differently to win the title, Captain Darren Sammy disclosed they have to win matches. He added they have the guys to make it happen, and they are looking forward to their match tomorrow.
In my team has a part to play in helping St. Lucia Zooks win cricket matches, and look, that's why it's the CPL, you know, and it's not an island thing, you know. It's the best players around the Caribbean looking to help whichever franchise he's at to win. And Barnwell, with the experience he has here in Guyana, who knows, he definitely, if he's in the 11, has a part to play in winning cricket matches.
Coach of the Guyana Amazon Warriors, Johan Botha, and coach of the St. Lucia Zooks, James Foster, disclosed preparations for tomorrow's clash have been going very well. Botha relayed, the team's practice matches over the past 2 days have been going well and according to plan, highlighting that everyone is fit and ready. Meanwhile, Foster mentioned, despite the threatening hurricane and delayed flights, their players all made it and had a number of good days, adding they have been working very hard in preparing for their first match of the tournament. The 2019 Hero Caribbean Premier League bowled off earlier today at the Queen's Park Oval in Trinidad, with the Trinbago Knight Riders taking on the St. Kitts and Nevis Patriots. The Guyana Amazon Warriors will face the St. Lucia Zooks tomorrow at the Guyana National Stadium, Providence, from 18 hours. Chelsea Lee, reporter from MTV Sports Update.
The broadcasters for the Hero Caribbean Premier League have been confirmed for the 2019 tournament, which deals with the key partners in place in India, the United Kingdom, New Zealand, Australia, America, Canada, and South Africa.
In addition, the tournament will be live streamed over Twitter and Facebook, so no matter where you are in the world, you will be able to enjoy the biggest party in sport. With this excellent spread of broadcasters around the globe, the tournament is expecting an increase in viewership for the seventh successive year. Each game will be shown live with a highlight package being available for all their partners. In addition, CPL will be producing a weekly roundup magazine show that will focus on the best of the action from each week of the tournament. The Hero CPL will feature the best players from across the Caribbean and around the world. Among the broadcasting networks are the Grenada Broadcasting Network, SportsMax, Facebook, Twitter, CDN SportsMax Español, Fox Sports, DAZN, Willow, Star TV, Sky Sports, Supersport, E-Networks, Digicel Home and Entertainment, the National Lottery's V3 and CNC3. Chelsea Lee, reporter from MTV Sports Update.
Steve Smith once again had the measure of England's bowlers on his return to the Australia side on a rain-shortened first day in the fourth Ashes test at Old Trafford. Smith, who missed the third test with concussion, notched up a record-ending eighth successive Ashes half-century to end the day 6-0 out and take the tours to 170-3. Australia had been reduced to 28-2 after winning the toss, only for Smith to add 116 with Marinus Labuschagne, whose 6-7 was his fourth consecutive score in excess of 50. After the euphoria of England's extraordinary one-wicket win at Headingley, which levelled the series at 1-1, this was a subdued occasion thanks mainly to the bitter cold, blustery winds and persistent showers. Barstuart Broad's burst with a new ball, the home attack struggled to offer a sustained threat, matching the mood of a crowd which could raise the atmosphere above the elements. The players were not seen for 3 hours after they went off for lunch, and even though they managed to play through some rain, it got too heavy to prevent any further action after a late tee was taken at 17:30 British Standard Time. Still, even though only 44 overs were possible, Smith took Australia to a good position on a pitch that looks ideal for batting now, but may be difficult when England come to bat last. An Australia victory would see them retain the Ashes with a test to spare. The Ghana Football Federation has extended congratulations to former Golden Jaguars head coach Michael Johnson on his recent appointment as specialist coach with the English Football Association.
According to a release on Monday, Johnson will work along with Eddie Boothroyd with the men's under-21 team, and his appointment is part of the FA's Elite Coach Placement Program, done in partnership with the Professional Footballers Association. Johnson served as head coach in Guyana for just over a year, taking the senior men's national team to its inaugural appearance at the 2019 CONCACAF Gold Cup with a creditable performance. GFF's president Wayne Ford commended Johnson for aiding in the development of the Golden Jaguars. Chelsea Lee, reporter from MTV Sports Update.
Switzerland's Belinda Bencic put friendship aside to beat Croatia's Dana Vikic and reach her first Grand Slam semi-final at the US Open. The 13th seed, who knocked out defending champion Naomi Osaka in the previous round, won 7-6, 7-5, 6-3 against her good friend. She will face Canadian Bianca Andreescu or Belgian Elise Mertens next. The 22-year-old will now return to the top 10 of the world rankings for the first time in more than 3 years. She reached a career high 7th in February 2016 before injuries and wrist surgery left her as low as 328th. Bencic, who was knocked out of the French Open by Vikic in May, got the better of her hitting partner this time round in a match full of baseline rallies. Last week, Archery Guyana members Wayne Gerald Diabro and Devin Prasad participated in the World Archery Approved Tournament 7720 qualification in Baltimore, Canada.
The two archers kicked things off in Baltimore with half of an hour of practice, then shooting the first 720 during the morning session of the tournament. Diabro racked up a score of 626 and Prasad 620. After a break, the afternoon session commenced with the other 72, the second 720 round, after which Diabro secured a 603 and Prasad emerged with a 644, elevating his ranking. Prasad is ranked 9th in Canada, while Diabro is ranked 17th. Archery Guyana continues to stand behind their two highest ranked archers as they continue to represent Guyana. Chelsea Lee, reporter from MTV Sports Update.
More news after the break. Stay with us.
Over the years, ISG has been providing all sectors across Guyana with quality products and outstanding customer service. Proud distributor of NP and Ultra lubricants, engineered for tropical conditions. International trucks and parts, leading the change. SEM Machinery, a Caterpillar brand, SKF Bearings and Mounted Products, Napa Batteries, Tide Power Generators. Discover the greatest source of power. Industrial Supply of Guyana Inc., the best opportunity to make the right choice.
Welcome back. You're still with MTV's News Update. In the region, rescuers have begun to reach areas of the northern Bahamas devastated by Hurricane Dorian, with aerial images showing a trail of destruction. PM Hubert Minis said some areas had been decimated and expected the current death toll of 7 would rise. The hurricane winds that hit the Abaco Islands equaled the highest ever recorded at landfall, and Grand Bahama also suffered severe damage and floods. Dorian has moved off north but still threatens the eastern U.S. seaboard. Forecasters have warned it could make landfall on the coast of South or North Carolina tomorrow. Although the hurricane has weakened to a Category 2 storm, with maximum sustained winds of 105 miles per hour, it has grown larger in area. On the international scale, members of Parliament have backed a bill to block a no-deal Brexit, which could trigger Boris Johnson to seek a general election. Opposition MPs and Tory rebels ensure the bill passed by 327 votes to 299. The bill forces the PM to ask for an extension beyond the 31st of October Brexit deadline if a deal has not been agreed with the EU. But Mr. Johnson has warned he would push for an immediate vote on an early general election if it went through. MPs also voted on amendments to the bill put forward by MPs, but chosen by the Deputy Speaker. One amendment appeared to pass without a vote, as no tellers were available to count the votes against it, says BBC parliamentary correspondent Mark Darcy. It was put forward by Labour's Stephen Kinnock to force an extension to the Brexit deadline to allow MPs to vote on Labour's proposed changes to former Prime Minister Theresa May's withdrawal agreement back in May. And that has brought us to the end of regional and international news. Now let's take a look at the Guyana Stock Exchange closing prices for trading session 8:41. This is where we will wrap up this evening's broadcast, but before we go, here's a reminder of our top stories. Hinterland infrastructure is another top priority of the next PPPC government, says the party's presidential candidate Irfan Ali. Nandalal weary of more attempts to delay long overdue general and regional elections. Gunmen bound and robbed mother and daughter in broad daylight as out-of-control crime continues. And in sport, Guyana Amazon Warriors looking to open CPL 2019 campaign on a winning note. Catch your rebroadcast at 23 hours today and at 6 hours 30 tomorrow. On behalf of our news and technical teams, I'm Ashley Scotland. Good night.